Thank you, sir. Nothing much is left after your exhaustive talk, but one aspect which will be different here is if you are, what Dr. Sudhir explained was in an institutional format, how the EMR is best used. How many of us in the audience are in the private practice right now? So that is quite a good number. So probably you may be confused how to implement it in your practice. So this is, in this I would attempt to explain to you another perspective, because when I moved from Shankar Nidralaya to my private practice, this is one thing I missed most, because we had got so used to electronic system there, and in private practice it was so difficult to implement everything there. So I just picked up some small points of the EMR, what we had learned there, and which could be used in my patient care and also in development of my practice. So here we start. This is, he has already told, uses the most important advantage of medical record is record keeping, research, as he has already explained, analysis, how you are performing. This is very important in marketing yourself, because as a private practitioner, you don't have anyone to market. You have to market yourself with your patient care and small methods using EMR. And there are various myths about EMR all of us have as a private practitioner, how should we implement. I will try to break those myths. So when I moved into practice, I wanted to do something different from what others were doing, and especially in practice, the penetration of EMR still even now is very low. And when you give a good neat printed prescription to the patient, it definitely carries an impression and helps the patient in having a better overview of his problem, and he is more inclined to come back to you when he sees that you are much more organized than anyone who is doing it on paper. So as a single man practice, started about 3 years back, slowly, brick by brick, you keep on building your records, and as you can see, in a very short period, we have at least 32,000 files with us, the patient records with us, and this will keep on building as you grow slowly in your practice. In private practice, what do we, most of the times we feel, we spend so much time in working up the patient, we do not keep the record with us, we give the prescription back to the patient, and when the patient comes back to us, he doesn't have that paper. So we always have a backup that prescription, and whenever a patient has come again without his record, we will have various search criteria for that patient, and we can always pull out his record from our EMR. And that helps our job easier, because next time we are not seeing him as a new patient, we are seeing him as a follow-up patient. Suppose, just for example, I am a pediatric ophthalmologist, so I get a lot of kits from the NGO Missionaries of Charity, which all of us know, which was founded by Mother Teresa. And over a period of time, I do free eye checkup for those children, and any child reporting to that organization comes for eye checkup to us. So we have a data now. We have a data of 121 of these children who have come for eye checkup, and we can do an analysis of the eye problems and various systemic malformations these children are having. Why they land in an orphanage? There are other issues also. Same thing, if you want to pull up files of patients with autism, you can just pull it up at one click. Data analysis, that is one important thing. See, when we are doing as a private practitioner, when we are giving paper files, we actually don't have any data of how many patients we have seen at the end of the month, whether our practice is growing or is decreasing over a month on month or year on year basis. So EMR will definitely help us in analyzing whether we are doing things correctly or not. So as you can see here, daily report is important, that daily how many patients you are seeing, how many patients are waiting outside in your room, in the waiting room, that you can see with the panel on the main screen. OPD performance, whether you are doing well in your OPD or not, whether your practice is improving or not. And best way to do is month by month, year on year, and month by month you will have to compare, because generally in private practice your practice fluctuates month by month. Some of the months are good, some winter months are better, summer months are poor. So best way to analyze it is to compare same month of that year with the same month of this year, the previous year with this year. So that is how you can analyze your OPD performance and OT performance as well. And in private practice, you are not competing with anyone, you are competing with yourself. So your data of previous years is important to analyze. One important thing which I saw in Dr. Sudhir's analysis, and which was quite matching with mine, is the number of new patients what you see per month. That is the important data to analyze whether you are doing things correctly or not. If you have a large number of your patients who are old patients and coming back to you, and there are not much new patients, then probably you need to rethink, because for your practice to grow, you have to have more and more new patients in the system. So there has to be a check system in which you are able to analyze the number of new patients you are seeing every month. Since I am a pediatric ophthalmologist, I would like to keep a watch on how many pediatric patients form a part of my practice or not. So again, that is, there is another check which I have been seeing over a period of 4 years now, and definitely it is around 50% of my OPD is pediatric patients, and I have been able to maintain that over a period of 4 years. That means I am not digressing from my core specialty. There is always a temptation to digress towards cataract, towards other things, but your strength is your specialty and you have to preserve that. So there has to be a check in that. We have a lot of referral doctors in our practice, so you can have data of a particular, of every referral doctor, how many patients he had sent last year and how many patients he has sent this year. And if it is increasing, same, or reducing. If it is drastically reducing, probably you have not done something correctly by which he lost confidence in you, and you can talk to him and find out that. So that is another analysis which is important. Marketing. We cannot market ourselves as our mobile phone or any other product is done. So we have to have subtle ways to do our own marketing. Just for example, this is one example. Colgate toothpaste, over a period of time it was losing popularity, its volume was decreasing. So what did they do? Just to increase their profitability, they just increased the pore size of their toothpaste marginally, maybe 10%, which increased the usage of the toothpaste, and without anyone knowing, they improved their profitability. This doesn't hold true for our system, but it's just a illustration. So what do we do? Whenever a patient comes and he's registered in the system, there goes a welcome message to the patient that, dear, the name of the patient, your medical record department number with this doctor is this. Please keep preserve this for future reference. That creates an impression that your doctor is serious about your health and wants to keep things in a systematic manner. Appointment reminder goes to every patient. Suppose I have entered 6 months, it goes about 1 week before that, automatic SMS goes to the patient that your appointment is due. And please report to the, please contact the hospital for confirming the same. What happened in between, it ran very smoothly for first one and a half years. Then government had some dry regulations came, and most of these SMS will not get delivered in DND phone numbers. And then I knew that this was actually working. That time my patients came, started asking me that, why are you not sending reminder SMSs now? So we had a solution for that. If you have your own patient and they have given a consent that these SMS can go, then you can get it converted into a transactional SMS. So transactional SMS will get delivered even into DND numbers, and this is working well after that. Festival greetings, it works well. Your patients feel good when you greet them in important festivals. Custom SMS, what Dr. Sudhir was telling, it really works. Suppose a child, and especially in patching, when the compliance is so difficult, you have to keep on reminding, hitting them again and again that patching has to be there. So when you see a child, maybe you enter in the system that 1 month later, one automatic SMS has to go that dear this patient's name, hope that you are patching your eyes as advised. That reinforces the treatment. And when the child comes back to you, maybe 2 to 3 months later, they give a better history that yes, they have been patching. Because ultimately, you want your patient to benefit. Health promotion SMS, these are some of the ethical ways of marketing yourself. So, and definitely it has made difference. Myth, it slows down your speed. No, it doesn't slow down your speed, because in Shankar Nidralaya we were given a royal treatment. We would have 2 rooms to see patients. One, we would see a patient in one room and go to the next room. And then also we would see about 80 to 100 patients. In private practice, you do not have a luxury, and then, even then with EMR, on a day in which I would have 3 to 4 OTs in the morning and then I would start OPD, I have seen almost 78 to 80 patients in a day. So that myth is not correct that it slows down your speed. Even with paper, you will not be able to see that many patients with fundus examination of every patient in one room. There are some online facilities also. What I have got developed is a custom made, but now more and more companies are realizing the benefit of it and they are providing online facility. Even Shankar Nidralaya has a facility in which private practitioners can probably take those services, and the payment has to be done on a per patient basis. So that is one way it can be done. Thank you so much.